Hey everybody, nice to see you again. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to talk about filtration again, and the filtration in this tank, which is the Biohome Maxi Ultimate that I've been using. Had it in there for just over a year now, so I wanted to let you know what the results were and in comparison to some of my other tanks. So like I said, this is my big Discus display tank. It's been running with Biohome filter media for just over a year now. I published some results around about month 4 where we looked at what effect it was having on nitrates. So I just wanted to let you know what's going on a year later, so we can have a look at some of the common complaints or questions or statements that people make and see whether or not they hold true. So you've seen this before. This is my sump underneath the main display tank. I've got a couple of sections here full of Biohome media, which is this stuff here that you can see. I keep it all in filter bags so it's easy to move around and clean if I need to. I've only ever really cleaned it once properly, and it's been fine. A lot of people will see comments, and I get questions quite often saying, oh, has your Biohome disintegrated yet? It certainly isn't showing any signs of doing that. Let me put it that way. It looks the same coloration. It's not changed in form, shape, or texture. It's not gone spongy, which one person asked me whether or not that happened. It's effectively exactly the same. Now, the reason that Biohome is getting a bit of a different rep than some other medias is that it gives you this full cycle filtration, which means that as well as dealing with ammonia and nitrites in your aquarium water, it also deals with nitrates, and it can do that at fairly fast flows. Nitrate removal, or the anaerobic bacteria cultivation, because it's the anaerobic bacteria that eats that up, it tends to be in fairly slow moving and low oxygen environments. So if you have fast moving water, it's very hard to achieve that. But it's the makeup of the Biohome itself that allows that to happen, and because it's got thousands and thousands of tiny little tunnels and valleys within it, and it's so porous, that does create that environment where that kind of bacteria can grow, and it can process the nitrates as well. Now, that's not to say that you can skip water changes and things like that, because traditionally you would use your live plants and water changes to get rid of the nitrates in an aquarium. And just because you've got some Biohome and it is working and doing your full cycle filtration for you, doesn't mean that you can skip water changes altogether. It just means you can maybe prolong them or delay doing them a bit more. And you can be confident that your aquarium's not got high nitrates in it waiting for you to do a water change. So, all in all, that seems pretty good. And it's one of the reasons that when I started the Aquarium Adventures website and selling some products on there, I wanted to get products that I actually used and liked. So that was one of the first ones that I was trying to stock on there. So this isn't a sponsored video or anything like that, it's just that I do like this product and genuinely think it is a good product. So what I've been doing is, as well as having this tank running, I've been logging all my water tests on this tank as well as all my other tanks, and I've got some tanks that are running canister filters with other similar media, like ceramic media or alpha grog mostly, and some bio rings, and as well some that are just running sponge filters and water changes and various different routines. So I've kind of compiled a list to contrast and compare, because they're all using the same water sources. So all my tanks are fed from HMA filters, which we've talked about before. The water comes in through there, straight into the tank. It's not stored or pre-treated in any way. So all the water sources are exactly the same. It's just different filtrations. Now, it's not exactly laboratory conditions or anything like that, but it's quite indicative. So let's go and take a look at those results. So, I just happen to be one of those sad cases that likes to do water tests all the time, and I keep a spreadsheet of all the results for my various tanks and systems. So, I've chosen 4 to show you here that are kind of slightly different. So, we've got the Discus tank, which is the Biohome tank. It is manually water changed. I tend to go for twice a week.
Sometimes a bit more, sometimes a bit less. That's the nature of manual changes. We have some tanks in the fish room, another manual tank, which is my planted tank. Now, it's not always been a planted tank, so it was, in previous guises, a rainbow tank and various other things. So that's why you might see some variation there. We've got the Crebensis tank. Oh, well, the planted tank, again, it is a manual water change tank. Then we've got the Crebensis tank, which was a very heavily stocked tank on automatic water change, which the stock has been dwindled down over time. So you can see the effect there. And then we've got the puffer tank, which has been a puffer tank for best part of a year for the whole time. The stock hasn't changed that much at all. It, again, is on an automatic water change, so a very controlled environment. So these are just some different tanks to show you some different setups and scenarios with different stocking, that type of thing. It's very much not a scientific laboratory conditions and scientific experiment or anything along those lines, but hopefully it will give you some indication of various things. So let's first off look at the Discus tank. So I'll put a graph up here somewhere, hopefully. And what's that showing you is the last year's worth, and this is an average, and same for every tank, it's an average of all the tests that I take throughout the month. What I tend to do is normally I will test just before the water change. So if I've done 6 tests that month, that will be before the water change is done and then averaged out, which is giving you these readings, which you can see now. They started back at 40 parts per million. My tap water, I think, is roughly about 20 parts per million usually. I don't always test that very often, so there could be some variation there. But as you can see, starts at 40 parts per million, drops down ever so slightly, and then about month 5 is where you start to see the rapid decreases. Now, I've never managed to get it to go to 0, but that, whether that's an anomaly with the test kit or not, I'm not entirely sure, but it's fairly consistent at kind of 5 parts per million, just a touch of colour in that nitrate test. I use the API Freshwater Master kit. I've also used some dipsticks as well to try and get some values and some baselines there, and they roughly come out the same. I'd like to do some more testing, because I quite enjoy water testing, which is a very strange thing to say. So I'll maybe try another experiment with lots of different types of test kits to see what results we get there. But so that's the Biohome tank. It is consistently now very low nitrates. There's nothing, and now obviously the plants have grown massively over that time. But I don't think that is what has done it, because it doesn't correlate with the timing that I can see in the graph. And they're still continuing to grow with very low nitrates. So I don't know. To me, that says fairly plainly that that's the Biohome that's doing this stuff. If we compare that to, for example, the puffer tank. So there's a tank that hasn't had many changes, but it does have an automatic water change routine going on. Again, fed from an HMA filter, just drips in and overflows constantly, 24 hours a day. It's a tank that's fairly well controlled. The stock hasn't changed or anything along those lines. But if you see the figures there, they bounce between 20 and 40 parts per million. If you take an average over the year, it's about 30. Not entirely sure why we've got such a variance there, but I guess it could be the amount of feeding that's going in there, depending when the tests were taken. But yeah, that is what it is. If we look at the crib tank, which is another tank that's on an automatic water change, but it's a fairly heavily stocked tank, or it was at least, that was always kind of, 40 was a low for that tank. I remember trying to increase the amount of volume that was changing the water in there, because I was a bit worried about the nitrates. But over time, I've dwindled the stock down a little bit, and that's come more under control, as you can see by the numbers there. So they're kind of settled in round about 20 now. And then if we look at the planted tank, which is another manually changed tank, again, it wasn't always a planted tank. It used to have rainbows and various other things, so that has changed. Again, when it was stocked, sitting at kind of 40 parts per million. Now that I've just changed it over to a planted tank, I think it's going to start coming down a little bit more there. But there you are. I'll put the 4 graphs up here so you can compare and contrast. But my interpretation of this is that the Biohome is doing something, which is why I think it is actually something that does what it says on the tin, which is more than most products do these days. But let me know what you think in the comments. I've not got the time to do a proper scientific test on this. So this is about as good as it's going to get. It's a year in. I'm a consumer who's still really happy with this product. In fact, I'm so happy I've started to sell it myself. Ask me any questions you want down below in the comments, or let me know what you think of my testing techniques or any of the numbers that I'm spitting out there. But I can't recommend it highly enough. By all means, go and check out Pond Guru's channel. He's got lots more information on all the various different types of Biohome. And if you want to, check out my website. And remember, as always, click that subscribe button if you don't want to miss any more videos. And I'll see you next time. Thank you very much.